I've always been a distant admirer of the Mega Man series. When the first six games were released as the Legacy Collection on PS4, I happily took the opportunity to finally experience it. So far, I've only completed the first one, and my opinion of it is overwhelmingly positive. It's challenging, rewarding, and very satisfying to play. The added puzzle of figuring out which order to complete the stages in adds an extra level of depth to the game, something which has rarely been seen in the genre since. Outside of the Mega Man series itself, of course. It also has an amazing soundtrack that's upbeat, fun, and comes with a hint of seriousness and cynicism, a perfect representation of what the gameplay has in store. The gameplay itself has two main facets, shooting and platforming. The shooting is very responsive and becomes increasingly fun as you accumulate the boss's weapons that you get after you beat them at the end of each core stage. Most of players' complaints seem to be related to Mega Man's platforming though. Many describe his movement as heavy, clunky and imprecise, and I actually generally agree. I think that the main problem with how Mega Man moves is that there's a cognitive disconnect between how you instinctively feel he should move and how he actually does. His running and jumping are very momentum based, meaning that you're often required to do some of the game's more difficult jumps on the run. Even then, his movement feels quite heavy, and this is also contradicted by the way he slides along the ground, whether you're running along or trying to land properly from a jump. Ultimately, you might end up feeling as though Mega Man's ground movement should be equally as heavy as his aerial movement, and it can instead feel like the opposite. However, and this is true of all of Mega Man's flaws in my opinion, the inconsistency of his movement is a telltale sign of ambition. The decision to create a style of movement that was momentum based was highly ambitious, and even though they didn't nail it until later iterations in the series, its influence was monumental. This is a perfect example of why the best games aren't necessarily the most polished. Sometimes a flaw can be an indication that the developers were taking a risk and trying something different, but maybe they didn't quite perfect what they were going for. There are too few games taking risks nowadays, and far too many that are simply clones of their predecessors, never daring to try anything new. As the PS4 version of Mega Man is identical to the NES one, I came across another flaw, the abundance of slowdown, which mainly occurs when there are too many enemies on screen, or if you happen to shoot one of the exploding types. Again, this is a sign that the developers were testing the limitations of the NES, which I'd never criticize a game for. Doing so would absolutely be denigration. Another of the game's criticisms is that it's too hard, but it's not really, especially if you're using the Elecman trick, which most people consider okay. Dr. Wily's stage is comfortably more difficult than the rest of the game though, so I can see why people might think the difficulty is ramped up suddenly. I could go on and on and on about the mechanics of the game and giving an overall review, but that's fucking boring. In fact, I actually did that initially. Then I completely rewrote this review because I fucking bored myself to tears talking about when it came out, who made it, how it's laid out, all that shit you can get from a million other people. I've given myself a challenge, and you should try it too, to try to think of a developer's intentions next time you see a flaw in the game. Maybe we're unfairly painting all flaws with the same brush, when some of them may actually be the result of risk-taking and creativity, two things that are becoming really hard to find in the modern gaming industry. Mega Man is one of the very rare games that I genuinely can't find anything bad to say about, mainly due to what I've explained, that the game's flaws are actually a sign of its ambition, which make them far less irritating and far more forgivable. That doesn't mean it's the greatest game of all time, or even that it's the best iteration in the series. It doesn't even mean it's an outstanding game or an amazing game. It just means that while there are valid criticisms about the game, they may be grounded in reasons that are actually quite commendable and should be encouraged. It is a great game, so it earns itself an 8 out of 10 on my very well thought out reviewing scale, something which also seems to be basically fucking non-existent in gaming media. Anyway, I'll save that rant for an upcoming video. Like and subscribe if you found the video interesting, and most of all, let me know your thoughts. Can you think of examples of games with excusable flaws? Do you agree with what I'm saying? Do you think you might look at flaws differently in games now? Do you think I'm talking absolute shit? That is also extremely likely. Comment below. Thank you for watching, and go play some games.